Newton law of cooling. In this experiment, we will try to prove the Newton law of cooling with the help of water. This is the oven which we have used. This is the calorimeter which contains the water. So temperature of this water in the calorimeter is raised to 100 centigrade. I have written. Number one is this is a calorimeter container, basically, right? You can say, right? This is hot water in this container, right? This water at a room temperature. Third one. Second one is the hot water which we have this placed in the oven, right? This one. So accordingly, we have heated down this water in this container, right, and put in the calorimeter, and this is cooled up to a particular temperature, right? Then we have started the reading. How we have started the reading, right? Suppose that I have started at 63.5 degrees centigrade, right? Earlier temperature was 100 degrees centigrade. Then it was cooled and temperature was now 63.5 degrees centigrade, and time shown is 1:37 on mobile I have taken, right? After 2 minutes reading was this one, right? So because of depending upon the sunny temperature, temperature will decrease, right? Accordingly, now again at the time, this time 256 seconds, temperature was 60 degree. So accordingly, I have noted on the reading, right? And according to time, so now at this time, reading is this one, and at this time, 301, reading was this one, right? So at different timings, I have taken the reading, right? Similarly, you can see here on 72.80 seconds, right? This was after 9 minutes, this was after 12 minutes. So accordingly, at different timings, I have noted down the temperature of this water, right, in the calorimeter. This is 48. So temperature on this thermometer will be 48, and temperature on this thermometer is 52 degrees centigrade. So by taking this one, right, now you can see after the 13 minutes, this is the reading on thermometer, right? And after this 9:58 seconds means 15 minutes, 15.58, right? So this at this time, you can see 9:58 seconds, right? I have taken this reading of this thermometer. So accordingly, we have noted down the up to the 43 degree centigrade, right? In this time, this is 44 degree centigrade at this time, and similarly up to this 37 seconds, this was reading, and up to the 38 degree centigrade, this was the reading. This 37 degree centigrade is at after 1700 seconds, right? So in this way, we can note down the reading, right? This lowest reading I have taken, that is after 1837 seconds, right? After this time, temperature of the water was 35 degrees centigrade. After this, now the table starts. This is the time in seconds I have written. This is the room temperature at that time. This is a constant temperature, because room temperature, whole the experiment was done in the room, right? So temperature of room was constant. So temperature of the water in the calorimeter, so that container was placed in the calorimeter, and so temperature of water which was taken in this container, placed in the calorimeter, this is the reading. That at 1:37 seconds, this was the reading. These were the readings, right? And this is a temperature I have shown, right? That if you subtract this one from this one, this one and this one, two, this will be the reading. Similarly, this one 42 degrees centigrade. So all these temperatures are taken in the degree centigrade. After that, I have drawn the graph. Graph is between the temperature of water which is placed in the calorimeter, right? Now this side you have taken that one. Then time in seconds, right? So what I have done is, then I have this graph, you can see this is almost not straight line, no chord in between, you can say. Now we have drawn, I have drawn a straight line at a particular point, right? And drawn a tangent at this point, and then find the slope at a particular particular temperature, right? I suppose this, at this temperature, you can see slope will be y2 minus y1 divided by x2 minus x1. Since this OX2 and OX1 is approximately equal, right? In this way, I have drawn the lines. Okay. Now this is the table. This is for the temperature, right? If at this temperature, slope was 21 multiplied by 10 to the power minus 3, similarly 31 multiplied by 10 to the power minus 3, similarly 32 also, 38 also, 44 also, and 56 into 10 to the power 3 degrees centigrade, right? This is the slope at a particular temperature, right? Now, this is basically at this values I have taken calculated slopes. If you decrease this value from the room temperature, this will be your value. If you draw a graph between this slope and the temperature of the water and minus 70 temperature, right? This graph will be a straight line. That is a proof for the Newton law of cooling. Thank you.